Well, it all happened way back in 1977. She swam the Digri Pukhri non-stop.
Several times national champion hua. Punctual and sincerity was in coaching.
Mithu was a brilliant freestyler, swimmer and competing in a lot of nationals and international meet. She won her first national freestyle medal in the 50 meter freestyle.
As a sportsman, वो फाइटर था, सारा इंडिया को भी पता था या आसाम को भी डेफिनेटली पता था, वो एक इंडिया नंबर वन स्विमर था.
Everybody knows how great swimmer she was, but when I say Mithu, it's like she's just another name of energy.
कहते हैं है वही सुरमा इस जग में जो अपनी राह बनाता है, कोई चलता है पदचिन्हों पर और कोई खुद पदचिन्ह बनाता है. नमस्कार, मैं हूं नवीश और आप सभी का स्वागत करता हूं आज के इस एपिसोड में द चैलेंजर्स. वैसे आज के एपिसोड के जो हमारे गेस्ट है वो है स्विमिंग सेंसेशन, अ स्टार, द स्पोर्ट्स वुमन, द स्विमर मिठू बोरुआ. जी हाँ, जिन्होंने कई राष्ट्रीय और अंतर्राष्ट्रीय पदक जीता है. तो चलिए इनसे मुखातिब होते हैं.
At present, Mithu plays the role of a homemaker, a wife of a cricketer and mother of another budding cricketer, Riyan Parag, who just got selected in under-19 Indian team. So you can say sports runs in the family.
Aapke personal life mein, who's that motivator or some person that inspired you?
Oh, well, I started very early. That was around, say, 2.5 years old when I was...
You were barely 2.5 years.
Yes, 77.
Acha.
So, that point of time, motivation or somebody motivating me did not come up as
a question.
Because I was too small to understand things. But then, as gradually as I grew up, Papa was always behind me as a solid rock. And he always said that, you know, I should wear the Indian colors no matter when. And I should complete my education.
And since I was a sportsman, I wanted my daughter to be a sportsman. And that is how it all started. It is not that sports hinders studies, not at all. I have proved it in my own children. My own children are doing very well in studies. And Mithu is an example. She is an MA in English.
It was always Papa behind me. And my mother was a homemaker. So I took motivation from her also as well, because, you know, I have been encouraged by my family to a very large extent. And though she didn't know about sports, she always encouraged me to do the best that I was doing.
Okay.
And that's why, you know, these two have been the pillar of my strength.
Growing up, Mithu Bora was very famous, yes. But for me, she was just my older sister who used to pamper me like anything. Representing India, going abroad, all that meant only one thing to me, that was gifts. Because I was so much pampered by her, I used to get a lot of gifts from her.
Mithu Bora ko bachpan se hi pani se bahut pyar tha aur sabko ye baat nazar mein aa gaya tha. After all, history was waiting to be created.
Well, it all happened way back in 1977. As a 2-year-old, you could make her do anything provided you gave her a bucket of water. And in fact, a stubborn girl that she was, it was difficult to make her eat her food at regular time or to go to bed. But whenever you mentioned a bucket of water or you gave it to her, you could make her do the job. So it influenced me, gave me the impression that she is fond of water and aquatics, that is swimming, would be the best sports for her.
Mithu ke papa ne Mithu ki swimming training isi Digholi Pukhuri se shuru kiya tha. ये एक नेचुरल पूल है विदाउट एनी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और सेफ्टी मेजर्स एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. Mithu की माँ इतनी छोटी बच्ची को इतने बड़े और गहरे नेचुरल पूल में स्विमिंग ट्रेनिंग के खिलाफ थी. आफ्टर ऑल शी फियर फॉर हर डॉटर्स सेफ्टी.
द बेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ इट वाज मदर्स एग्नी एंड हर बिग आईज टू मी व्हेन आई वांटेड टू गिव हर टू द वाटर्स. कमिंग फ्रॉम अ ऑर्डिनरी सिंपल ब्राह्मण फैमिली, she was not addicted to all these. So I had to face a lot of music from her. But finally, when she came to know of her achievement, a tide changed. And now, then she began having faith on me that my daughter is in very good hands.
और 1977 में मीठू की स्विमिंग शुरू हुआ। ढाई साल की ये लड़की 22 फुट गहरे पानी में अपनी कमाल दिखाना शुरू कर दिया।
She took to the waters under the care of Anwar Rasool and Roman Das at Duggal Kukri on the 1st of July 1977.
मैंने उसको पिताजी को बोला था आपका लड़की का अभी उम्र कितना हुआ? तो वो बोला अभी उसका उम्र 2 साल 5 महीना हुआ। तो मैंने इसको बोला ठीक है बोरुआ आप वो लड़की को आप लेके आइए आज इवनिंग। तो इसके बाद मैं पानी में इसको उतार लिया, उतार करके इसको थोड़ा पैडलिंग वगैरह किया। पहले थोड़ा डर हुआ, हो ही गया इतना छोटा बच्चा है, तो इसको मैं गोद में लेके थोड़ा घुमाया फिराया है। इसके बाद उसको पहला रोज करीबन 1 घंटा का माफिक मैंने इसको स्विमिंग सिखाया। तो नेक्स्ट डे वो लेके आया है, इसके बाद मैं इसको थोड़ा ट्यूब का अंदर लेके थोड़ा घुमाया है करीबन 1/2 आवर। तीसरा दिन मैं इसको ट्यूब से निकाल के हाथ में लेके इसको फ्लोटिंग किया है। फ्लोटिंग करके करीबन 10 मिनट का माफी इसको फ्लोटिंग किया। इसके बाद मैंने डिगली पूरी लंबा हम इसको धीरे धीरे इसको विदाउट ट्यूब उसको मैं ले किया है।
एंड ऑन द 21st डे शी स्वैम द डिगली पुखरी नॉन स्टॉप
410 मीटर। तो इसको मैं क्रॉस करवा दिया।
ऑन द 27th डे She swam the Digholi Pukhri non-stop both ways.
तो उसका बाद में मिठू ये होगी।
बहुत ही कम उम्र से ही मिठू अपनी स्विमिंग टैलेंट दिखाना शुरू कर दिया था। असम में सबको खबर हो गया था ये लड़की एक ना एक दिन देश का नाम रोशन करेगी।
And after that, the BP Chalia swimming pool came up. She used to go there, and subsequently. She swam her first national in 85, age group national, where she swam with the great Bula Chaudhary. In Bombay, Mithu won the silver medal in the 50 meters freestyle, and that was a starting point. After that came the Asiad at Bombay. Mithu was selected on the strength of her achievement in the nationals, and in the Asiad, Mithu won the first gold medal for Assam. In a tournament by winning the best stroke 50 meters gold medal.
Mithu started training under me in the national coaching camp during the Asian Age Group camps in Mumbai. From the very beginning, she was sincere and hardworking. Outside the pool, she was a bit naughty too.
Mr. Barua ke ghar par ye deewar bhare hai medal aur trophy se. Ek champion ki ghar ki ek pehchan. जो हर किसी से अलग है।
Well, Mithu ji, I presume this is a very special chunk of your room, right? I can see this rows and columns of medals here. तो बहुत सारे medals हैं जो कि बहुत ही ज़्यादा attractive और बहुत ही ज़्यादा खूबसूरत है, which is for you like a place of exclamation, I would say. तो ये medal जो है, this looks quite interesting.
Actually, this is a medal. Mm-hmm. This was the first national gold I won in. 85,
Achha, this
Lucknow,
is the 85
yes, which was Assam's first goal as well. I remember swimming this race. In the heats, I had the best timing, which nobody, you know, even thought about that I would get the best timing in the heat. And then I was given lane 4, which is given to the swimmer with the best timing in the heat. When I got lane 4, then, you know, everybody was like up on their feet. Come on, come on, Mane, you have to get the goal. Papa was there with me. There were other officials from the Assam Swimming Association. That's when they realized that, yes, we are going to get our first medal. I was very small at that point, I was 9.5 years old. Papa said, you take a good start and swim your heart out. So I was on the blocks, I took a good start, I swam, and when I touched, I came first. I also didn't realize that I had touched first. So there were the people from the association who came and, you know, congratulated me while I was still in the water. That's when I knew I had won a gold. That was my first gold medal ever.
There are certain other medals which are also significant.
This medal here.
Okay.
This was the South Games gold I got in
1991.
Wow. And this was my first major gold medal, major tournament. Previous to that, 85 first international medal I won was in a age group meet, but this was the first major, that's the Open Championship. Mm-hmm. So SAF Games 91 was my first goal in the Open Championship.
So internationally, it holds special mention in your life. Yes. So would you like to share something about this?
See, all competitions are the same, and every event that I have taken part, it has been followed by so many celebrations, and previous to that have been days and days of hard work. Hmm. So that's all I can say about winning these medals. All these medals are international and national medals that I have won in my life, and all are dear to me.
Okay.
I value each and everyone on the same level and the same league.
मीठू बोरुआ ने जब अपनी स्विमिंग शुरू किया था, तब असम में ट्रेनिंग का अच्छा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं था, फिर भी उनकी प्रतिभा को कोई रोक नहीं सका.
There was nothing. It was NIL nil. It was only perseverance, tenacity and very hard work. And I really had to labor with me too.
What she achieved during that time with the limited resources and everything else with that competition was spectacular and really something.
हम लोग हमेशा बोलते हैं कि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं है, ये नहीं है, वो नहीं है. वो मैं नहीं मानता हूँ एक्चुअली. ऐसा मेरे साथ भी एग्जाम्पल है. मतलब जो क्रिकेटर है जो अलग स्टेट से खेला था, उड़ीसा से मेरा दोस्त है आशीष दास, तब भी वो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं था, लेकिन वो इंडिया खेला था. मिठू भी तो जहाँ पे जब खेला था पहले तो ये भी नहीं था, फिर सिर्फ एक ही था, बिमला प्रसाद सलीहा स्विमिंग पूल था, वही था. और वो तो डिघली पुखुरी में वो स्टार्ट किया था, वो तो स्विमिंग पूल भी नहीं है. वहाँ से स्टार्ट करके अगर इंडिया नंबर वन बन सकता है या 10 साल इंडिया खेल सकता है, तो फिर अभी नहीं होगा या नहीं बन पाएगा, वो मैं नहीं मानूंगा.
85 when I won my first national gold in Lucknow, and the same year I won my first international medal, which was the first national and international medal for Assam ever, both in men and women.
Ji.
Ever. So after that, 89 I went to Japan for the Asia Pacific.
Okay.
Then I was the national sub junior champion from 86 to 88, and then with a record in 100 meters breaststroke. 89, I won 2 silvers and a bronze. Okay. 91, I participated in the 5th national games. I got 2 golds and a silver. And the same year, I went to Russia for advanced coaching. 92, I was selected for the Asian Championship in Beijing. And then 93, the Asia Pacific. 98, Malaysia was my last international meet.
लेकिन ये कामयाबी हासिल करने के लिए मीठू को वो कीमत चुकाना पड़ा जो एक बच्चे के लिए बहुत भारी था.
A sportsman, if he wants to be a sportsman of value, he must sacrifice normal life.
Leave many things behind. Some few things might be very dear to you, but you can't do that if you have to be in sports.
Then naturally, she was dedicated, punctual, and sincerity was in coaching.
Going to the swimming pool at 7, coming home at 8, having her food and going to school at 8:30, coming back at 3, going again to the pool at 4:30 was quite a job.
As a young child, you are with your parents and going for social outings, then marriages, birthday parties, okay, then usually you go there, you like to be part of all those things. But Mithu, because of her schedule, at times me, my father and my mother, we used to go out of town, leaving her behind as well with my aunt, because she can't miss swimming. So all those things as a kid, we didn't get much. Okay, so she had to be always, had to transfer her life, schedule her life as per swimming timings.
I can recall my grandma's death in 1984. She expired. Mm-hmm. And then I represented India in 1985. That was the first time I represented India. And she left in 84. So that was very bad that happened. We were in a mourning state, as usual, as obvious that a family goes through. So Papa, before going to the cremation ground, he told my mother that, ask me to go for her training. I was too young, but then also it really touched me.
It was not easy, I tell you. She was the inspiration behind my effort. Without her inspiration, without her tenacity, I would have been a complete failure.
1994 National Games Pune में organized किया गया था. पूरे देश की sports talents वहाँ जमा हुआ था. Assam was short of few gold medals as Mithu represented the state, और वो काफी form में भी थी. अगर वो इसमें गोल्ड जीत लेती है तो एशियाड में नेशनल स्विमिंग टीम में उनका भर्ती होना तय था।
My aim was the Asian Games at least, but that couldn't be achieved because of other reasons, not because of our ability, because of other reasons.
नेशनल गेम्स की 100 मीटर फ्रीस्टाइल फाइनल्स पर एक ऐसा हादसा हुआ जो हर किसी के सपनों के बाहर था।
In fact, in 1994, she became the fastest swimmer in India, was given the gold. But half an hour later, I don't know how, it was announced that Meetu had been disqualified.
I don't like talking much about it because that has been a very dark phase of my career.
इतने दिनों की मेहनत, कोशिश एंड ट्रेनिंग सब बेकार हो गया। उनसे गोल्ड मेडल का हक छीन लिया गया। The reason given was false start.
If the gold medal has been given, how can she be disqualified again?
And in the final, I did not take a false start. I was declared the winner on the touchpad. Times of India and all other leading newspapers came and congratulated me. They interviewed me for the gold. And after half an hour, suddenly see the screen, showing that I have been disqualified and Nisha Millet has been given the gold.
ऐसा लगा जैसे सब खत्म हो गया। Meetu was totally heartbroken.
This is totally, something. It's a planned game by a few of our, unloved ones, okay, who were jealous by her achievements so young.
I don't know why that happened, but then it was so, my career was almost hit by a bomb, you can say, I was very, very hurt.
बचपन से जिन्होंने सिर्फ अपनी मेहनत और टैलेंट की वजूद पर इतना कुछ हासिल किया, एक पलक में जैसे सब कुछ खत्म हो गया।
Of course she was sad, she was very sad, but then it didn't stop her from achieving the next goals.
वो फाइटर था मेरे हिसाब से, वो मेन पॉइंट है, और उसके मतलब वो डेडिकेटेड था कि हाँ वो क्या करना चाहते हैं वो अपना लाइफ में, वो इम्पोर्टेंट है एज ए स्पोर्ट्समैन।
Meetu ने प्रोटेस्ट भी किया एंड अपील्ड फॉर जस्टिस, तो उनको फेडरेशन ने एक साल के लिए कोई भी कॉम्पिटिशन में पार्टिसिपेट करने में पाबंदी लगा दी।
I never gave up. The person who disqualified me, I went up and told him, "See, Mr. Whoever he was, that you can stop me for a year. They banned me for a year because I protested and I appealed. But next year, I'm sure, and I tell you that you would be the one garlanding me with a medal in the medal podium. I'll see that I do that."
She had this fighting spirit in her always, so that didn't let her down so much. Maybe for a year she was sad, but again, once she was back to the pool, she thought that she has to go further than that. She started planning for the future goals. So it didn't stop her. It became more of a challenge to her to achieve more than what had happened.
Next day, in 95, during the nationals at Kolkata, I got the silver. And it was him who, it really matched. I don't know, it was God's wish, perhaps. He happened to, garland me with the silver medal. I recall the moment I had told him, "See, Mister, I had told you last year, and this has happened because I was correct. I was the truth which you allegedly, wanted to stump down."
Meetu continued her journey in sports career for few more years, collecting more national and international medals for the country and making Assam proud again. After all, she was a challenger.
Several time national champion hua. एशिया पैसिफिक खेला, उधर में भी वो उसको मेडल मिला।
She played to few internationals after that, after what had happened in 94.
1999 में Meetu Borua ने स्विमिंग से रिटायर किया और अब she is happy being the homemaker along with a fulfilling job in the Indian Railways.
Well, she's a very good cook, a very good artist. She really can paint anything and sketch. She's good in sketching. And then she's very prim and proper in everything she does.
सुना है कि यू आर सच एन अमेजिंग मैनेजर व्हेन इट कम्स टू मैनेजिंग योर होम, तो इसके बारे में आपको जरूर कुछ कहना होगा बिकॉज़ यू हैव बीन टेकिंग केयर ऑफ द एवरीथिंग।
व्हेन यू आर गिवन रिस्पांसिबिलिटीज, इट इज योर ड्यूटी टू कैरी देम आउट। एंड व्हेन आई गॉट मैरिड, इट वाज डिसाइडेड अर्लियर व्हेन आई वाज ऑन विद माय करियर दैट द डे आई गेट मैरिड इट वुड बी फॉर माय फैमिली एंड माय हस्बैंड एंड माय चिल्ड्रन और चाइल्ड व्हाटएवर।
आपने ये डिसीजन क्यों लिया?
While I was touring, participating in tournaments all over the world and all over India, I never got that family bonding, you know. I was never there in the house. I was always on the run. Hmm. So I should be able to give them time, and I could give them time only when I, you know, was done with my career. So that was a very deliberate decision on my part. And so when I got married, when I came into this family fold, my father-in-law was ailing. So, you know, I looked after him. Then Rihan was born. Porag was on with his career. And so that is how I got into the whole thing. I started managing everything.
My wife hai, lekin wo sab kuch hai ultimately. 4-5 mahina wo office se chutti leke yahan pe baith ke wo ye ghar banaya.
I'm a house proud, actually. I like my house to be beautiful. I like my home to be very warm. I like it to be spick and span. And I've got a taste. And when I enter home after office in the evening, and you know, it's mine, my beautiful place.
That actually reflects with the interior of the house. Actually.
It is just my taste, my feelings, and my, you know, decor.
Aur is baar Rihan ki baari hai.
मीठू और पराग के सुपुत्र रियान पराग इज अ राइजिंग स्टार जो कम उम्र में ही अपने टैलेंट के बल पर अंडर 19 इंडियन टीम में सिलेक्ट हुए हैं।
Her son is doing so good. Of course, if somebody leaves with a powerhouse, I mean, what's going to happen? You have to do good.
मोटिवेशन तो हम लोगों की तरफ से या मीठू के तरफ से तो हमेशा रह रहे हैं। जैसे जो सपोर्ट चाहिए और जैसे हम दोनों ही स्पोर्ट्समैन हैं वो हम लोगों को भी पता है या क्या फैसिलिटीज चाहिए क्या डाइट चाहिए वो सब मिठू हैंडल करते हैं
एज अ फ्रेंड शी विल लाइक वेरी प्रोटेक्टिव आई से यू नो टेलिंग मी नॉट गो आउट लाइक नॉट गो आउट विद बैड कंपनी एंड ऑल लाइक हेल्पिंग मी इन द डिफरेंट लाइफ सिचुएशंस
एक चैंपियन स्पोर्ट्स वुमन होने के नाते मीठू रियान को डिसिप्लिन और हार्ड वर्क पर भरोसा करने की शिक्षा देते हैं
It has to be discipline, you know. She discipline all sorts of, you know, everything, like whether it be home, whether it be an office, whether it be a meeting, or whether it be an out, like together, we're going out somewhere. To be disciplined at all times, you know. So that has helped me a lot, yeah.
Do you still miss that? Do you sometimes feel really emotional or you get choked sometimes?
No. It has never happened with me. I'm so happy now, actually. I'm very happy now. All the hard work I had to do, I don't have to do that hard work. I live life peacefully and I'm very happy with whatever God has given me. And I'm so lucky to have Porag as my husband and Rian as my son. I've been blessed with a wonderful son. I'm absolutely very happy. Touch wood and God's grace. I don't have any regrets. I don't miss anything from the pool.
So you're living a life of contentment.
Yes, and whatever happened, whatever I did not get was not, I think it was not there to happen in this lifetime. And whatever I achieved, I think it was all God's blessing and God's will.
और डियर व्यूअर इस एपिसोड में हमने आपको रूबरू करवाया स्विमा मीठू बोरवा को उनसे एक सीख मिली कि पेशेंस एंड परसिवियरेंस बियर्स फ्रूट आपको बता दूं ये वही जगह है दिघोली पुखुड़ी जहां से उन्होंने शुरुआत की थी अब आपको मैं एक बात बताना चाहूँगा कि अमेनिटीज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वगैरह वगैरह हो या ना हो अगर जिद चाह नेक हो मनोबल सही हो और सच्ची हो तो कुछ भी असंभव नहीं है ये हमें दिखा मीठू बोरवा से और समझ भी आया हम उनको सराहते हैं थैंक यू सो मच एंड ऑफ कोर्स ये था इस एपिसोड में मीठू बोरवा एज द चैलेंजर अगले हफ्ते हम इंट्रोड्यूस करवाएंगे किसी और चैलेंजर से बट टिल देन यू डू रिमेंबर यू आर ऑल्सो द चैलेंजर थैंक्स फॉर बीइंग विद अस